Hey Aries, it's Teresa with One Love, One Light. Welcome to your Enchanted Forest message. Let's see what Spirit has for you. Holy Spirit, what do we have for Aries? And we have slow and steady. So I do feel like they're asking you to stop and enjoy and take your time. The journey, it's all about the journey. That's what I'm getting here. But let's see what the book has to say. Number 12. Slow and steady wins the race. Remember the old cliche, slow and steady wins the race? This is a time for easy movement, unhurried steps, and a steady heart. Trust that taking life at a more leisurely pace will give you greater access to your dreams. Slowing down allows more contact with the juicier elements of your life. Savor them. So it's really about exactly what I said, enjoying the journey and not being so focused on the destination. What else do we have? Raven spirit, truth. I feel like, you know, they're both pointed in the same direction, and it's about really looking at things and seeing the truth of a situation. We're going to read this one as well because there is a really strong message that comes with the Raven spirit, and that's number 32. The soul loves the truth. Find your truth, speak your truth, live your truth. Be fearless in your journey. Follow your inner guidance. Let go of what is not authentic and sincere in life. Be a shining example of truth for others. So I feel like, it's not so much about the destination, but the journey, because you're finding yourself. You're finding your authenticity, your truth. What else do we have? What else do we have? For Aries. And we have rebirth, spring, Shiva Lingam, number 21. So we have 12 and 21, so it's kind of mirroring each other, but I'm feeling like there's something where you're getting this brand new start, and I feel like this is a journey that you're not going to rush through. You're going to savor. You're going to, it's like you're getting a second chance at something. So let's go ahead and read what Rebirth has to say as well. Rebirth number 21. You have called this card today as confirmation you are currently undergoing a time of rebirth. This is an opportunity for you to shed your old skin and old ways that are no longer serving you, and a time to birth deeper aspects of yourself. This is a natural part of life when the old is no longer required and an opportunity is offered for you to birth into a new state of being or consciousness. Do you feel like the universe has pulled the carpet from under you and all you used to know is no longer working? Is there a dead end at every turn? Are you being challenged by situations and people around you? Are you experiencing a stirring inside and noticing that your tolerance level has decreased? These are all signs that a rebirth is in order. It can be uncomfortable when you are encouraged to let go of aspects of yourself you may have thought kept you safe. You are encouraged to trust in the guidance of your own soul and surrender to a deeper sense of yourself as you fall into the fire and rise from the ashes. It is a powerful time in your life, so make sure to honor yourself in this sacred time of expansion and growth. Be still, listen to your gut instincts, and follow the path of your heart, even if it scares you. Make sure to listen to your own wisdom and dance to the beat of your own drum. So there's more there about listening to your heart and listening to your intuition and also really being your authentic self. And so I feel like sometimes we have to get a fresh start in order to really uncover that truth of ourselves. So let's go ahead and see what else comes out. What else do we have for Aries? This could be a new job, a new relationship, moving house, moving to a new city, changing your social circle. We have love, the Lover's card, number 6. So I feel like there's something that more clearly aligns with you that you are going to come into contact with. What else do we have? And we have the 8 of Air, but you're not necessarily seeing the way forward. This is the 8 of Swords. So it's kind of a self-imposed prison where you're feeling like there's no way out. But this prison has been built by you and your negative thoughts. So this is about letting go of those thoughts and rebirthing, coming out fresh and ready for something new. What's the challenge here? And we have the 10 of Earth. So I feel like this, the challenge here is community and longevity and finances and home. So this is about feeling like you are prosperous and abundant. And I feel like maybe you feel like you don't have the money or the finances to support, or you don't have the support that you need in order to move forward. But that's all just a lie in your head. You know, it's just the bad self-talk that leads you to believe you can't move forward. What is the advice from Spirit here? And we have the World. So there's definitely chapters that need to end and new ones to begin. But this is about finding the solution, the key. You have that keyhole there. And it's like unlocking the next phase, the next realm, the next dimension for you. What is the outcome here? And we have the King of Air. This is where you've been extremely focused on your intellect, the logical side, but all these cards have asked you to listen to your intuition. Yes, you have the wisdom, you have the intellect, but this is also about trusting that intuition and following your heart. The bottom of the deck, we have the Page, the Messenger of Air. So the Page, is this the Page or is this the Knight? I always forget in this deck, but regardless, it's like a message that's coming through, some type of communication or something that you're learning. And I feel like it's a learning something about yourself. But let's go ahead and clarify. Show me why the Lovers is here. And we have the 7 of Visions, the 7 of Cups. And I feel like, yeah, there's things that there may be many options, but there's only one that truly aligns with your vibration, with your heart and soul. Show me this 8 of Air, 8 of Swords. And we have the 2 of Pentacles. So, yeah, I feel like this is about a choice and just following your priorities. What is your priority? What is, you know, like weighing things out and then seeing what your priority is here. What is this 10 of Pentacles about? And we have the King of Swords again. So you have that twice here. So you may definitely be dealing with an air sign. Could be an Aquarius, or doesn't have to be, Gemini, Libra. But I feel like it's like you're giving your power to someone else here. You're giving your power to someone else, your power of abundance and prosperity. And the truth of the matter is that you are just as powerful. You just have to take that power back. With the King of Swords here twice, you are seeking the truth, but this truth is within you. Show me this World card. And we have the Enchanter, the Magician. So this is you manifesting this. It's like, looks like the same thing, manifesting options, and yet you're overwhelmed by your options. That's what I'm getting here. Show me this King of Swords. And we have the 10 of Pentacles. So two repeating energies. It's like when you become the King of Swords and instead of letting this other King of Swords take your power, when you become the King of Swords and realize your own wisdom, your own intellect, and your own power, then you can create this abundance and be able to share with your family and friends and feel a place of comfort and longevity. The bottom of the deck, we have the Ten of Swords. So this is all about your own thoughts are what defeats you. And I feel like this is, you know, before you even get started, you know, that's what I'm getting here. It's like, that's what defeats you, your own self message here. So it's about transforming that and starting fresh so that you don't feel like the world is already against you before you even get started. All right, let's get some guidance here. We have time. Embrace in the dewdrops of life before they disappear with the morning sun. Caution, tread softly so as not to disturb the woodland floor. And I feel like that's with the slow and steady as well. Surprises, under the most ordinary stone is an undisturbed garden. One more. Reconnect. Secrets lurk in the captive shadows deep in the woods. So I feel like reconnect with your intuition, because even if you can't see something, you can feel its vibration there. That's what I'm getting. And at the bottom of the deck, resilience. Stay as strong as evergreen trees. So those are the messages that came through for you. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. Please, please, please subscribe. And remember, the universe has your back, and so do I. Take care.